Hello students, welcome to 59th class on current affairs for 2019 prelims and mains. In this class, I will be dealing with the importance of Statue of Unity. This is one topic that will remain quite hot till next year's mains. And there are chances that something related to Statue of Unity might be asked. But in this class, I will not be dealing with the facts of the Statue of Unity, how tall it is, how much time has been taken, where it is placed, all those things you will get in the PDF that will be attached with this class. In this class, I will be discussing about Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel's achievements. Now, this is very, very important. This is something that will help you to understand why the statue has been named as the Statue of Unity. And in order to understand this, we need to go in the background of this. Now, what is the background? When India got its independence, jab azadi mila, azadi ke saath, we had two problems. The first problem was the problem of partition. There was a lot of bloodshed. There was a lot of turmoil that unfolded along with the independence. And second important thing was that when India got its independence, along with that, 500 plus princely states had also got the independence. Now, the British had offered them three choices. The first choice was either the princely states should go with India, or they should go with Pakistan, or they should remain independent. So these were the three choices that were offered to the princely states. Now, had all these princely states would have remained independent, India would not have been a nation of the type that now it is. So we owe a lot to Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Now, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel, he was a lawyer, and throughout India's independence movement, he had polished his qualities, and it was out of those qualities that he was able to convince the princes of the princely states to join India. He has used a two-pronged approach. First of all, he had offered them a carrot, and the second thing was the stick. So using carrot and stick policy, Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel was able to get back all these princely states and make them join India. So when it comes to these princely states, he had asked all these princely states that their privileges, that their perks, that their alliances and their respect and their recognition, that all will be maintained even in independent India. But what they need to do was just to sign an instrument of accession with India. Now, what is meant by instrument of accession? Instrument of accession, it is a legal document through which, by which a princely state had offered India sovereignty over four important subjects. First was defense, finance, communication and foreign relations. Defense, finance, communication and foreign relations. ये चार चीजें हैं सरदार वल्लभभाई पटेल ने कहा कि ये चार चीजें आप हमें दे दीजिए. बहुत सारे प्रिंसली स्टेट्स को ऐसे कन्विंस किया गया कि बाकी जो भी आपका पेंशन रहेगा, प्राइवेट पर्सेस जो होंगे वो आपको दिए जाएंगे. So he had convinced the princely states by offering them lot of allurements, lot of perks. So jitna princely state tha, sara India ke saath join kar gaya. But it was not that it was easy with respect to every princely state. There were princely states like Hyderabad, like Jodhpur, like Junagadh, like Bhopal, like Kashmir, and like Travancore, ये कुछ इस तरह की पेंसिली स्टेट्स थे, त्रावणकोर केरला में, जोधपुर राजस्थान में, जम्मू एंड कश्मीर का मुद्दा एंड हैदराबाद. सो ही हैड यूज्ड विद रिस्पेक्ट टू दीज प्रिंसली स्टेट्स द स्टिक पॉलिसी सो दैट दे कैन साइन इंस्ट्रूमेंट ऑफ एक्सेशन. एंड वंस ही हैड डेल्ट विद ऑल दीज प्रिंसली स्टेट्स, इंडिया बिकेम व्हाट इंडिया इज नाउ. इंडिया वॉज यूनाइटेड. He was able to preserve the unity of India, and that is why the name, the Statue of Unity. That was the most important role that was placed by Sardar Vallabhbhai Patel. Now, why is BJP government trying to offer a lot of respect and recognition to a leader who belonged to a Congress party? BJP is trying to create its own iconography. Now, what is iconography? पुराने बुजुर्गों को अपना बताना और ये बताना कि वो हमारे साथ एसोसिएटेड थे, ये सबके साथ प्रॉब्लम रहा है. इवन इफ यू विल स्टडी मेडिवल हिस्ट्री और एंशियंट हिस्ट्री, ऑल द किंग, ऑल द रूलर्स, दे हैव बीन एलेजाइजिंग देमसेल्फ टू बिलोंग टू सम रिवर्ड लीडर और रूलर इन द पास्ट. उससे आपको रिस्पेक्ट एंड रिकॉग्निशन मिल जाता है. सिर्फ रिकॉग्निशन के लिए आप किसी को अपना पापा बनाने का कोशिश कर रहे हो. दिस वाज समथिंग दैट इज बीइंग डन बाय द करंट गवर्नमेंट. दे आर ट्राइंग टू क्रिएट एन इकोनोग्राफी. अकॉर्डिंग टू देम गांधी बिलोंग्स टू देम, अकॉर्डिंग टू देम सरदार वल्लभभाई पटेल बिलोंग्स टू देम, एटसेट्रा एटसेट्रा. बट दैट इज नॉट द रियलिटी. इनफैक्ट इन 1948 इट वाज सरदार वल्लभभाई पटेल हु हैड द चार्ज ऑफ होम मिनिस्ट्री एट दैट पॉइंट ऑफ टाइम. ही वाज अ डिप्टी प्राइम मिनिस्टर, ही वाज द होम मिनिस्टर ऑल्सो, ही वाज आईएनबी मिनिस्टर टू. So when he was a home minister, he had banned RSS, Rashtriya Swayam Sevak Sangh, for indulging in communalist activities, for indulging in such activities that would have endangered the peace of India. So presently that the Statue of Unity that Government of India has built, the reason for that is the unity he was able to create and preserve. So this was all for the class. In case you have any sort of doubt, you can contact me at 84594-0000. And you must join our answer writing classes and a test series program. That will give you a huge jump in mains examination. Because one-to-one evaluation for the test series will be done. Answers will be evaluated by me and the feedback will be given. That will help you to improve your writing skills. And writing skill is the most important component in civil services preparation. It is not about understanding of the topic. It's about how you will be writing the topics. So this was all for the day. Bye-bye. Take care. Have a nice day.